tell me you were gonna kill it. Never jump into a pile of leaves with a wet sucker. I'll hold the ball, and you come running and kick it.
Oh, brother.
I don't mind your dishonesty half as much as I mind your opinion of me. You must think I'm stupid.
This time you can trust me. See? Here's a signed document, testifying that I promise not to pull it away.
It is signed. It's a signed document. I guess if you have a signed document in your possession, you can't go wrong. This year, I'm really gonna kick that football.
Ah! Peculiar thing about this document, it was never notarized.
Dear Great Pumpkin, I'm looking forward to your arrival on Halloween night. I hope you will bring me lots of presents. This is the time of year to write to the Great Pumpkin. On Halloween night, the Great Pumpkin rises out of his pumpkin patch and flies through the air with his bag of toys for all the children.
You must be crazy. When are you going to stop believing in something that isn't true?
When you stop believing in that fellow with the red suit and the white beard who goes ho, ho, ho.
We are obviously separated by denominational differences.
You must get discouraged because more people believe in Santa Claus than in you. Well, let's face it, Santa Claus has had more publicity. But being number two, perhaps you try harder. There are three things I have learned never to discuss with people: religion, politics, and the Great Pumpkin. Everyone tells me you are a fake, but I believe in you. P.S. If you really are a fake, don't tell me. I don't want to know. On Halloween night, the Great Pumpkin rises out of the pumpkin patch and flies through the air to bring toys to all the good little children everywhere.
All you have to do is walk up to a house, ring the doorbell, and say tricks or treats.
Are you sure it's legal?
Of course it's legal.
I wouldn't want to be accused of taking part in a rumble.
Is that you, Patty?
No.
Where is Charlie Brown?
Here I am. I had a little trouble with the scissors.
Hey, have you come to sing pumpkin carols? He flies through the air and brings toys to all the children of the world.
That's a good story.
You don't believe the story of the Great Pumpkin? I thought little girls always believed everything that was told to them. I thought little girls were innocent and trusting.
Welcome to the 20th century.
I'm glad you came back, Sally. We'll just sit here in this pumpkin patch, and you'll see the Great Pumpkin with your own eyes.
If you try to hold my hand, I'll slug you.
Each year, the Great Pumpkin rises out of the pumpkin patch that he thinks is the most sincere. He's got to pick this one. He's got to. I don't see how a pumpkin patch can be more sincere than this one. You can look all around and there's not a sign of hypocrisy. Nothing but sincerity as far as the eye can see.
Can I have an extra piece of candy for my stupid brother? He couldn't come with us because he's sitting in a pumpkin patch, waiting for the Great Pumpkin.
Charlie Brown, you'll be the perfect model.
Thank you,
Charlie Brown. You were a perfect model.
Patch on Halloween night. I'd have said they were crazy.
Just think, Sally, when the great pumpkin rises out of the pumpkin patch, we'll be here to see him. What's that? I hear the great pumpkin.
There he is! It's the great pumpkin! He's rising up out of the pumpkin patch.
What happened? Did I faint? What did he leave us? Did he leave us any toys?
I was robbed. I spent the whole night waiting with the great pumpkin when I could have been out for tricks or treats. Halloween is over and I've missed it. You blockhead! You kept me up all night waiting for the great pumpkin. And all that came was a beagle. I didn't get a chance to go out for tricks or treats. And it was all your fault. Also, what a fool I was. I could have had candy, apples, and gum. And cookies and money and all sorts of things. But no, I had to listen to you. You blockhead. What a fool I was. Trick or treats come only once a year, and I miss it by sitting in a pumpkin patch with a blockhead. You owe me restitution!
You heard about fury in a woman scorned, haven't you?
Yes, I guess I have.
Well, that's nothing compared to the fury of a woman who has been cheated out of tricks or treats. If the great pumpkin comes, I'll still put in a good word for you. Good grief, I said if. I meant when he comes! I'm doomed. One little slip like that can cause a great pumpkin to pass you by.